Our journey today is going to be creating a new reality for you. So now then, if you would like to be so kind as to oblige us for this next practice, all you need to do is sit comfortably, legs comfortable, feet on the ground, as best as possible, your back supported. And as many of you are familiar with this process, begin a series of very nice, gentle, deep and relaxing breaths. Inhaling deeply, and with every exhalation, feel yourselves, allow yourselves to relax deeper and deeper. Whether your eyes are closed or open, allow your shoulders to relax, so all tensions are simply released like rain falling off a roof. All tensions running off your back and shoulders. Your deep breathing relaxing you more and more, deeper and deeper still. And allow the gentle sensation of relaxation to spread throughout the entire body, from the backs and shoulders to the chest, down the arms, all the way throughout the entire body, from the backs and the shoulders to the chest, down the arms, all the way down to the very fingertips, and all the way down the body to the lower back and abdomen, all the way down, all tension just running off your bodies like so much rain off a roof, all the way down the legs, down towards the knees, the calves, down to the very shins, the ankles, and over the feet, all the way to the toes, all tension just dripping away, leaving you so that your relaxation can be deeper and more profound than you've ever allowed it to be. And whilst you are relaxing deeper and deeper and paying attention to the sound of my voice so that you hear all the words, notice and pay attention to the gentle rhythmic beating of your heart. And as you pay attention to the rhythmic beating of your heart, we will count from 1 to 10, and each number from 1 to 10 representing a step on stairs. And once we reach 10, you will find yourselves in a very safe, secure place. Now, with your hand on the handrail, we begin down the stairs. 1, 2, deeper still. 3 and 4. And just pause a moment on the fourth step. And just sense for your witness or observer self, that part of you that watches you, that looks at your experience of reality and comments upon it. Invite that part of yourself to come and join you down the stairs. to be with you, by your side, down each step with you. Very good, very nice. Now continue. 5, 6, deeper. 5 now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very nice and deeply relaxed. More so than before. More so than ever before. And feel very free now. Step onto this balcony, and we invite you to look at a series of events that pertain to your life that you can watch from the balcony as if you are watching perhaps days, each depicting various times in your life, and know that from the balcony you can even invite whatever it is that you determine is your essence, your greater self, your oversoul. Allow one scene from your life that may have held for you some emotional pain or challenge of some kind, and observe the goings on in this scene. Looking at it from above, as it were, from the balcony onto whatever stage this scene is playing out. Perhaps there are people involved or situations, and you can recognize thus a past self of yours from this lifetime, engaged in a scenario where you feel some degree of hurt or pain. We suggest that you ask your essence or higher self to assist you in directing loving energies, security, a sense of well-being, comfort, appreciation, however you determine and identify it, and ask your essence to assist you in directing this healing, salve or ointment love to the self involved in the scenario on the stage. If you so desire, you may even freeze the scene you are watching from the balcony and direct those loving, soothing, healing energies to the scene below. And if the scene below was perhaps dark, imagine or pretend that with the directing of your healing energies, it may become now light, vibrant healing, and let that energy infuse and completely be absorbed. And if you have frozen the frame, unfreeze it now, unpause it, and observe whatever transformations might have occurred there for you as the scene unfolds now and you are watching from the balcony. And after a moment, allow that scene to go its own way, to evolve and transform as it now has the power to. And invite another scene from your present life and observe it from the balcony. Look at some of the details. Observe the people and yourself included. And this time, ask essence or inner or higher self to begin assisting you in tapping into an even greater reservoir of healing and loving energies. A reservoir of infinite capacity, and that the energy, the infinite loving energy, begins to pour into you. As you are standing on the balcony, and it goes through your heart, and a beam of loving heart energy flows from this ocean of infinite capacity right through your heart and into the scene, so that it becomes transformed, that any pain, hurt or otherwise becomes transformed, that an understanding comes from it, that an evolution is the outcome, a transformation is the result. Within the scenario of the energy going through your heart, and allow that scene also to continue its own way and its own transformations. Return again to the balcony with yourself and higher self. Ask your essence or higher self to assist you in reaching out deep into memory, even if consciously you do not remember any details. Reach out into your infancy, into your birth, and even beyond your birth to the womb. And regardless of the thoughts that may have been expressed about you and towards you in the very early stages of your infancy, or even the stages within the womb, and ask your essence or higher self to once again tap deep into that infinite reservoir of universal loving energy into the very fabric of your being. Energy well up within you, filling you to the very brim until it begins to flow over even. And this time, instead of directing energies from the balcony, ask your essence or higher self to magically transport you to those scenes, so that in some form or another, tangibly or semi-tangibly, the loving energy that saturates and oversaturates your being and flows and is your being, and you in that loving energy form can reach out to the very young child or infant and embrace them with the energy, caress them with the energy, even infuse them with the energy, reaching deep into the body of the infant, into its mind, into your infant mind, even into the fetus in the womb, reaching its form, reaching your unborn form, reaching deep, deep within the energy idea. Reaching deep, deep now. even into the energy idea before you had a form. And with great loving tenderness, gentleness, and intent, you illuminate, saturate, infuse the being that you are with deep, heartfelt energy, assisting the infant or the unborn child in understanding that there may be times when there is a tendency to interpret life and living as something to be afraid of, something that they may hurt. But beneath those interpretations, there is something greater still than all of the fears, all of the worries and concerns, and that is a deep-rooted loving energy that stems from the universe itself. The infant or the unborn you with light and loving energy as best you can, share it from the depth of your heart, inviting the infant, born or unborn, to view life from a greater perspective, from a deep loving position, and allow the warmth of that loving exchange to soothe any thoughts the child born or unborn may have, and invite the child born or unborn to envision with you a bright, loving, adventurous life. And from your position, imagine or pretend with the child born or unborn this perspective makes life a completely different adventure, that though it may still have challenges, there are many loving tools and resources and a loving attitude to support it. And as that child grows into its future, its life is continuously transformed, so that the transformation reaches even you today. In this here and now, and a deep loving connection is established, enhancing a feeling of security, of safety, of strength, knowing that from now on you have the ability to connect with other aspects of your life in such a manner that surely your tomorrows are just as filled with safety, with love, with strength, and that life becomes the wonderful, loving playground that it's meant to be. And gently now, take leave of the idea of the born or unborn child. Ask your essence or higher self now to take you back towards the balcony, and allow the seeds to go into love, to be supported in love. And now thank your essence, your higher self, for its assistance, its loving support, and head back now towards the bottom of the first small staircase. We will begin going up that small staircase. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Heading towards once again that safe, secure place at the bottom of that larger staircase, bringing with you, deeply embedded into you, the experience that you have lived, feeling good about yourselves in every way possible, feeling refreshed, loved and secure. Now with your hand on the handrail, yourselves in every way, every which way, and in a moment we will count to three, and at three you can open your eyes, fully and completely awake and focused into the room that you're in. Three, allow all sensations to return to the body as normal. Two, you may wriggle your fingers and toes. Take a deep breath now. And one, open your eyes, fully awake and conscious, aware into the room, and know that any time you can simply give yourselves that loving and securing feeling regardless of situations. You can even do so at least once a day in any way you see fit. So in your loving self, I say thank you for being on this journey today with me. Namaste, Rosalie Miller.